Thank you. As the President made a policy statement, I've just, in a short time I have, picked a few issues which I would like to highlight from the policy statement. Now, one of the broad themes that he brought from the statement was that the problem facing this country is economic and it's not political. And I want to disagree with that statement right at the beginning, because there's economics, there's politics, and there is a political economy. And the problem facing this country is politics in a sense, and it is the rule of law that is a problem facing this country. So I would say that the President didn't really go to the root causes of the problem, but he was dealing with some of the issues on the surface. He emphasized that it was the law that was needed, and more laws had to be bringing, and we are not objecting to bringing laws. But the problem facing the country is to do more with the compliance of the law rather than the law. Nothing will change unless there is compliance with the law. If acts are violated, people need to be punished, of course through the judicial process. And therefore this is actually the problem. Those who are convicted in a court of law are sitting in this chamber, and they are making laws, and they are even trying to see if they can change the judges, the people who are sitting here, who are convicted by a court of law. This is almost making a joke of it. They want to make changes. Then if you look at it, going further in that speech, I see that we often don't meet the targets that have been set on the economy. It may be on revenue, it may be on something else. What we then do is we alter the targets. And we alter the targets, and then we say, ah, we have now met the new benchmark. The new targets have been met by us. It's really not that. We need to fix the loopholes. For example, tax concessions need to be fixed. Large-scale industries and often get tax concessions, and there is no even playing field. This needs to be fixed if we want to fix the economy. The sugar scam is one of that has been mentioned frequently. It's big business or it's friends and known people that get the benefits. And when you think about the pressure that the value-added tax, the VAT, has created on the middle class and on the poor, it is really, really a scandal that we have tax concessions and we are giving it to selected parties, but the pressure is being put on the public of this country. I understand that even casino taxes haven't been collected more recently. So how do we actually address these issues then? We have to address these issues. We don't talk about spending. Spending needs to be looked at, right? There was a research report that came out a week or two ago which said that the armed forces for food and for uniforms in 2022-2024 had spent 75 billion rupees. Research report, not my report. Research report talks about it. Now, on the other hand, the President, in a previous speech in here in Parliament, when I proposed that the tax-free income be increased from 100,000 to 200,000 so that the middle class gets some kind of a respite. These are honorable people who get in a bus or a train or a van or a car and go to work every single day, every single day. They look after their children, they look after their families, they look after their parents, their grandparents. They don't depend on the state. That's why I was proposing that the tax-free income be increased. That the President said that day in his speech that it will cost the government 63 billion. Contrast the 63 billion, which I have just told you about the 75 billion. We had to really look at it rationally. Even spending needs to be looked at. Transparency spending needs to be looked at. That is the point that I would like to make to the President, given his speech yesterday. Exports, he said exports were up, and he quoted a figure from 2022, which is 13.1 billion. I'm very happy when exports go up, because that's the only way for Sri Lanka. Exports must get primacy. But the actual number in 2023 was 11.9. It had actually come down from 13.1 to 11.9. It's nothing to celebrate. But I'm saying is, let's be truthful, let's be accurate, and let's get our exports up, because we need to get it. We must have sustainable growth. That's what this country needs. We need sustainable growth. We signed an FTA with Thailand just the other day. We just only saw it about 2 days ago. I haven't been able to read the full FTA because it's several pages. But one of the significant things in that FTA is that the concessions, the duty-free concessions, come starting from the 10th year onwards. Now, when we signed an FTA with India, we go for the duty-free concessions from year one. So market access from year one. This is coming 10 years down the road. So FTAs alone won't do. It is that the devil is in the details of an FTA. And we need to look at the details. Why aren't foreign investments coming? Foreign government restrictions. Electronic procurement is missing. Implementation is poor. And corruption is a big, big issue. And it has been brought to my notice that an FDI of nearly $100 million for a BOI proposal to establish an industrial site in Putlam has been sabotaged. The Sri Lanka Insurance Corporation has signed a 30-year agreement with Asha Minerals on the 10th of April 2023. And it found out that it's a paper company which doesn't have really a capital. Neither has it a GSMB license. Neither has it got experience in actually looking at minerals. But this company has been given. I must say this for the respect of the public servants. The boards are appointed by politicians and political appointees. But the Ministry of Finance had a Mrs. Walpola on the board. And she has objected to it. And I'm proud about it because I worked in that ministry. That
government, you have more 2 minutes.
That government servants have the guts to actually object when they see that there is something wrong. I tried to find out who was behind Putlam Ilmenite Limited. And I found out that Dilma, Access Engineering and Haley's are the owners of this company. So I am placing it before this house. Dushanaya Turan Kirima, Janadhipathuma Kiwa, Huru Allanawa Kiwa, හුරු අල්ලන්න බෑ කියලා කිව්වා හුරු අල්ලන්න ඕනේ කියලා කිව්වා එනම් මේ සඳහා පදනම් කරගත හැකි ශක්තිමත් නීති රීති පද්ධතියක් වාගේම විද්‍යාත්මක ක්‍රමවේදයක්ද අවශ්‍ය වෙනවා ඒවා ක්‍රියාත්මක කළ හැකි පුහුණු නිලධාරීන් අවශ්‍ය වෙනවා දූෂණ විරෝධී පනතක් ගෙනාවා නමුත් මම අහන්න කැමති ප්‍රශ්නය මේකයි ආර්ථික අර්බුදයක් තෙමෙයි මෙතන තියෙන දේශපාලන ශක්තියක් නැහැ ඒ නිසා තමයි මේක විසඳන්න බැරි ආර්ථික අර්බුදයට ඇත්තේ ආර්ථික විසඳුමක් විද්‍යාත්මක විසඳුමක් අවශ්‍යයි කියලා කිව්වා මැතිවරණයේදී ලබන ඡන්දය ඉලක්ක කරගෙන ඉටු කළ නොහැකි පොරොන්දු දීමෙන් ප්‍රලාප දොඩවන්න එපා කියලා කිව්වා ඊයේ කතාවේ සඳහන් කරපු දේවල් මම මෙතන කිව්වේ මම අහනවා ස්වාධීන නඩු පැවරීමේ කාර්යාලයක් ඇයි ඇති කරන්න බැරි ස්වාධීන නඩු පැවරීමේ කාර්යාලයක් ආණ්ඩු වෙන්න පුළුවන් ආණ්ඩු යන්න පුළුවන් නමුත් එතකොට ඒ නීතිය දිගින් දිගටම ක්‍රියාත්මක වෙනවා stolen assets recovery පනත ඒ කියන්නේ හොරු ඇල්ලීමට හොරකම් කරපු වත්කම් ලබා ගැනීමේ පනත ඇයි ඒක ඉක්මනට ගෙනන්නේ ගේනවා විතරක් නෙමෙයි පනත ක්‍රියාත්මක කිරීමේ වැඩපිළිවෙලයි ප්‍රමාද කරන්නේ ඇයි ඒක කරලා නැත්තේ කියලා මම අහනවා ඇයි මේව කරන්න බැරි මේව ආර්ථිකයේද මේක දේශපාලන අදිෂ්ඨානයේද කියලා ඒකට ජාත්‍යන්තර සහයෝගය ලබා දෙනවා මේක එක්සත් ජාතීන්ගේ වැඩපිළිවෙලක් එක්සත් ජාතීන්ගේ සහයෝගය ලබා දෙනවා නඩු ඇසීම ඉක්මන් කරන්න බැරි ඇයි කියන එක මම අවසන් කරනවා මෙහෙම ජනාධිපතිතුමා තව යෝජනාවක් ගෙනලා කිව්ව ක්‍රියාත්මක කරනවා කියලා දෙනවා කියලා කිව්වා ලක්ෂ මිලියන 200කට ඉඩම් දෙනවා කියලා කිව්වා මට අද වතගේ මතකයි දිනය ඔබරායි හෝටලේ 1990 විතර අවුරුදු 35කට උඩදී මම බැංකු සේවකෙක් වෙලා ඉන්නකොට හැමෝටම ආරාධනාවක් දුන්නා බැංකුවේ ප්‍රධානියට දුන්නා බැංකුවේ ප්‍රධානිය වෙනුවට ගියේ මම එතනට ගියේ ඒ ජනාධිපති රණසිංහ ප්‍රේමදාසගේ ආරාධනාව උඩ එදා විශේෂ දේශකෙක් හිටියා හර්නෑන්ඩෝ ඩෙ සෝටෝ කියලා පෙරු ජාතිකයෙක් එදා එතන හිටියේ ది අද පාත් කියන වෙනස් මාර්ගයක් කියන පොත ඔහු නිකුත් කළා ජනවාරි මාසෙ 1989 දී ඒ පොතේ කිව්වේ ඉඩම් නැති අයට ඉඩම් නීතිමයව ලබා දෙන්න කියලා තමයි එදා ඔහු සඳහන් කළේ
ඒකෙන් ඒ රටේ තිබුණ ත්‍රස්තවාදය තුරන් වුණා. ඒ රටේ තිබුණ ත්‍රස්තවාදය ජනාධිපති ප්‍රේමදාසයක දැකලා තමයි ඔහු කැඳවලා ඒක කළේ අවුරුදු 35කට උඩදී. මේක අපිට ඒක අවාසනාවන්ත සිද්ධියක්. ජනාධිපතිතුමා ත්‍රස්තවාදයෙන් නැති වුණා. නමුත් පෙරු රටේ ෂයිනින් පාත් ත්‍රස්තවාදයට තිත තිබ්බේ. ඒ වැඩ පිළිවෙල හරහයි තිබ්බේ. ඒක කරන්න ඉඩ තිබුණ නැහැ. ඉතින් මේක අලුත් දෙයක් නෙමෙයි. අවුරුදු 35කට උඩදී කරන්න තිබුණ දෙයක්. ඇයි මෙච්චර කල් ප්‍රමාද වුණේ කියන එක මම අහනවා. දැන්වත් හරියට විනිවිදභාවයෙන් නීතිමයව පරිසරයට හානියක් නොවන විදියට ඒක ක්‍රියා කරන්න කියලා මම ඉල්ලමින් මගේ කතාව අවසන් කරනවා. ලබා දුන්න වේලාවට බොහොම ස්තුතියි.
ගරු මහින්ද.